Hello students, this is Anthony Christy Melson, Department of Mathematics, BMS College of Engineering, bringing to you Lagrange's form of linear PDE, its solution. The Lagrange's form of linear PDE is defined by equation 1, where small p represents dou z by dou x and small q represents dou z by dou y. Capital P, Q and R are functions of x, y and z. The solution of equation 1 is given by equation 2, where u and v are independent functions of x, y and z. To solve the Lagrange's form of linear PDE, the first step is to identify the capital P, Q and R. Using this, we construct an auxiliary equation given by equation 1. Auxiliary equation is a supporting equation which helps in the solution of the main problem given. Now to solve equation 1, there are three possible cases. The first case, if we can choose a pair such that it reduces to a variable separable form, we can integrate that to get the solution u equal to c1. For example, if we choose dx by p equal to dy by q, then we should be able to eliminate z. If not, then choose a pair where the third variable can be eliminated. Similarly, we can choose another pair to get p equal to c2. It is not always possible to solve for two solutions u and v using case 1. So if we are able to solve u equal to c1, then we can use that in another pair to eliminate some of the variables and bring it to a variable separable form. Once we integrate and get a solution, we substitute for c1 to get v equal to c2. It is possible that case 1 and or case 2 fails. In such a case, we choose multipliers P1, Q1, R1 to construct equation 2. This equation 2 is equivalent to the auxiliary equation that we have constructed. P1, Q1, R1 are not arbitrarily chosen. They are chosen such that we get an integrable form d phi by phi. A special case is when the denominator of equation 2 becomes 0. Then if we pair it with any of the other ratios in the auxiliary equation, we get p1 dx plus q1 dy plus r1 dz equal to 0, which can be integrated. One has to note that more than one set of multipliers can also be chosen. To illustrate, we'll take this example, yzp minus xzq equal to xy. The auxiliary equation is dx by yz equal to dy by minus xz equal to dz by xy. To write the auxiliary equation, we need to compare equation 1 with the standard form of Lagrange's form of PDE, which gives Q, capital Q as minus xz. So we can choose the pair with dx and dy, which results in the elimination of z, and hence we can separate the variables and integrate to get x squared plus y squared equal to c1 as the solution, which gives us u equal to x squared plus y squared. Similarly, we can choose another pair such that the third variable can be eliminated. So if we choose the pair with dy and dz, we can eliminate x, separate the variables, and integrating, we get v equal to y squared plus z squared. As discussed earlier, The solution of Lagrange's form of linear PDE is in the form of f of u v equal to 0. Therefore, f of x squared plus y squared, which is u, and y squared plus z squared, which is v, equal to 0, is the solution of the given problem. We'll choose another problem, y squared zp plus x squared zq equal to xy squared. The auxiliary equation is given by equation 1. So as we can observe, we can choose dx by y squared z equal to dy by x squared z as the first pair. Eliminating z and separating the variables, we can integrate to get u equal to x cube minus y cube. Now if we observe the remaining pairs, if we choose dy and dz, we will not be able to eliminate x. There will be one x left out. So we choose dx by y squared z equal to dz by x y squared, which helps us in eliminating y squared. And separating the variables and integrating, we get v equal to x squared minus z squared. Therefore, the solution of the given PDE is f of u v equal to 0. Therefore, f of x cube minus y cube, comma x squared minus z squared equal to 0 will be the solution. We will have a look at an example where case 1 fails. So we have to make use of case 2. The auxiliary equation for this problem is given by equation 1. And a pretty obvious choice for the first solution would be dx by 1 equal to dy by 3. So the solution is given by equation 3. So we have u equal to y minus 3x. Now, any pair with dz as one of the options does not directly eliminate the third variable. If we choose dx equal to dz by 5z plus tan y minus 3x, we cannot directly eliminate y. So we make use of the solution of the first pair, that is y minus 3x equal to c1, which we can substitute here. As we can see, in equation 5, y has been eliminated with the substitution, which is now in the variable separable form, which can be integrated to get x equal to 1 by 5 log 5z plus tan of c1 plus 1 by 5 c2, which simplifies to v equal to 5x minus log 5z plus tan y minus 3x equal to c2. So now we have two independent solutions, u and v. Therefore, the solution of the given PDE is given by equation 8. One has to note that we cannot leave c1 in equation 6. That has to be substituted to eliminate c1, and we get only one arbitrary constant in equation 7. Another example of case 2, we take y squared plus z squared p minus xy cube plus zx equal to 0. Now this is not in the standard form of Lagrange's form of linear PDE. Therefore, the first step would be to rearrange it in the standard form, which is given by equation 1. Therefore, the auxiliary equation would be dx by y squared plus z squared equal to dy by minus xy equal to dz by minus zx. And the obvious choice for the first solution of the auxiliary equation would be dy by minus xy equal to dz by minus xz. Eliminating x and separating the variables, we can integrate to get log y equal to log z plus log c1. The arbitrary constant is chosen according to convenience. Therefore, we have y equal to c1z, and hence we can choose u as y by z. Now, if we choose dx by y squared plus z squared equal to dz by minus xz, we need to eliminate y. For that, we make use of equation 4. Therefore, equation 6 reduces to dx by c1z whole squared plus z squared equal to dz by minus xz. Separating the variables and integrating, we get equation 8. Now we have to substitute for c1 or c1 squared, which results in x squared equal to minus of y squared plus z squared plus c2, which further simplifies to x squared plus y squared plus z squared equal to c2. So we can choose v as x squared plus y squared plus z squared. Therefore, the solution of the given PDE would be f of u comma v equal to 0, which is f of y by z comma x squared plus y squared plus z squared equal to 0. In the next presentation, we will be having a look at how to solve Lagrange's form of linear PDE using case 3. Thank you.